जग का करने को उधार, कभी राम बन के रहमान बन के, कभी राम बन के रहमान बन के।
हर युग में हुआ साईं अवतार, जग का करने को उधार, कभी राम बन के रहमान बन के, कभी राम बन के रहमान बन के।
का रूप लिया कवि नानक की वाणी,
मोहम्मद का रूप लिया कवि नानक की वाणी,
शिव भोले कहाए कभी उपदेश ईसा की जुबानी,
शिव भोले कहलाए कभी उपदेश ईसा की जुबानी।
जब जब हुआ तब दूर किया अंधकार,
गीता ज्ञान बन के कुरान बन के, गीता ज्ञान बन के कुरान बन के। युग में हुआ साईं अवतार, जग का करने को उधार, कभी राम बन के रहमान बन के, कभी राम बन के रहमान बन के।
कृष्ण करिम करतार,
काबे में तू, काशी में तू, कृष्ण करिम करतार,
हर धरों में तू, जन जन में तू, कन कन में तेरी बहार,
हर धर्म में तू, जन जन में तू, कन कन में तेरी बहार।
तूने बंसी मधुर बजाई, भगतन की पीड़ मिटाई,
कभी श्याम बन के घन श्याम।
टू डिस्क्राइब भगवान बाबा, आई कैन ओनली थिंक ऑफ दी उपनिषद सेइंग यतो वाचो निवर्तन्ते अप्राप्य मनसा सह। दैट वाज द डिस्क्रिप्शन गिवन उपनिषद्स अबाउट ब्रह्मन, एंड व्हाट इट मीन्स इज दिस, दैट सुप्रीम ट्रूथ where from the words of man return unable to comprehend that truth and unable to describe it. Yato vacho nivartante aprapya nasasaha. The mind of man is not able to comprehend that truth, and words of man are not capable of describing that truth. That is the aptest description of Bhagavan Bhattu. It's impossible for anybody to comprehend his infinite glory, nor can one understand his real divine nature, because Baba defines all the rules of science as known to man, is above all the laws of nature. He is Satya Swarupa, Prema Swarupa, and also Satchidananda Swarupa. That is, he is the embodiment of love, he is the embodiment of truth, and he is the embodiment of bliss in its purest form. Such a finality is difficult to find on the earth, except when periodically avatars make their appearance on this earth whenever dharma declines.
I found in him such a depth of love which I do not think it is possible for any human being to give. After that I went to Puttaparthi at the time of the Dashera of the same year, and there I saw the Abhishek of Shirdi Baba which he used to make on the Dashera day. There was first the Abhishek of the Murti of Shirdi Baba with water, then with milk, and then with vibhuti, Kasturi would hold a pitcher turned upside down. Baba will put his hand inside, and there would be an avalanche of vibhuti coming down and pouring on the murti of Shirdi Baba. When Baba would remove his hand, there would be nothing, because the pitcher was empty. Then again, when he would put his hand, and there would be again a sort of a torrential flow of vibhuti. And that is how it went on for a few minutes.
In March 1971, when we were staying with Mr. Dharambira, the then governor of Karnataka, he suggested that we go with him to meet Baba. None of us had met him before that time. I had just taken over a new assignment, so I was not keen at that particular time of the morning to see Baba. So I told my wife that I was not going. She wanted to go, she could go. And we had an argument over that in our own room. And while this argument was going on, I was telling her, you go and I'm going to work. I'm interested in work, not the Babas and the people like that. Then he said, Governor Sahib, aap ki nakal rahe, to aap chaliye. So we had no option but to go, but I went rather reluctantly. When we reached Prasanthinagar, at Whitefield, Dharmiji introduced me to him, said, Swami, Air Marshal Mera hai, HAL ke chairman hai. To my surprise, he said to me, Tumko nahi aana mat aao, Bibi ke saath kai ko jhagda karta. Kaam karna bahut achha baat hai. Work is worship. Tum kaam karo. Baba log bhi aise time waste karte sabka. Now, that shook me, because I couldn't imagine that what I was discussing with her was known to him. Now that was my first impact, that here was somebody who was out of the ordinary and seemed to be present at any place and any place.
In my personal career, when I went to him, I was a rather prosperous advocate, that's a lawyer, a legal practitioner in the High Court. Within 1.5-2 years, at a very young age, Swami told me, even at the very first interview, you are not going to be an advocate for long. I have got other plans for you. And then within 2 years, at a very young age, I was a High Court judge. Then I was Chief Justice of the High Court. 5 years before I came to Supreme Court, Swami told me, at a time when I had never dreamt of coming to Supreme Court, Swami told me, you are going to get ready, you have got to go to Delhi, you are going to Supreme Court. And then I came to Supreme Court in January of 1981. In 1979, July, on Guru Purnima day, Swami announced in Puttaparthi to a devotee sitting on the veranda, Arad is appointed to Supreme Court. I mean, people started coming and congratulating me, which was very embarrassing, because at that time there was not the slightest move on the part of the powers that be here to make that appointment. And when Swami has said he appointed, I can't say it is not correct. So they were congratulating me, I had to receive the congratulations. But mind you, I returned from Puttaparthi to Ernakulam, that is Cochin, where I was Chief Justice of Kerala High Court. Next day, I returned there on the 17th was Guru Purnima day, 1979. I returned to Ernakulam on 20th or so. Next day in the evening, I get a call from the Chief Justice of India, asking me whether I would not join the Supreme Court as yet. That is how his sankalpa works. That is, in other words, even your material life is all guided by him. He is shaped by him. He takes charge of everything. I mean, one has to go through the vicissitudes of life, but you have got the courage that there is a great force always sustaining and supporting you. That is the thing. That's a great experience.
Once Baba asked me, do you know what is Sumangal Mala? I said, I couldn't understand what he said. I said, no, I don't know. Then immediately he came and he started producing the beads which I am wearing just now, mala. This mala. One after one, the beads were coming down from his hand and it became the whole mala. Then he said, this is called the Sumangal Mala and you have to wear it. This is for the protection of your husband, for the good well-being of your family. And then he was with so much love and affection. He gave me this mala and he himself put it in my neck.
I had a tear of the ligament of my left knee. I was having a lot of trouble climbing up the stairs and climb down. I had fixed up an appointment with Dr. Dholakia in Bombay for operated. That was in the month of May. But Baba always visits Dharma Kshetra, Bombay on 11th, 12th and 13th May. So Baba had come there, so I went there and I told Baba that I'm getting operated. So he looked at me and said, I don't think it is necessary. He materialized Vibhuti, gave it to me and said, divide it into three parts. Take one part on each day and you'll be all right. I did that and within a week I was all right, and since then I've forgotten that I ever had a tear of the ligament. There was no pain after that while climbing up or climbing down the stairs.
We had a serious problem with our son-in-law's illness. He was having some problem with stones in the kidney. Baba was against the operation. He was operated. Well, everything went okay. Till one fine day, we realized that his urinary passage had got blocked and he was deemed by the doctors to be very ill. So my wife, myself and our daughter went to Wild. Baba saw us at the gate. He walked up to us and said, "To, abhi sanlelo phirtan karta?" "Haan, Swami." "Kya ho gaya?" "Urine band ho gaya uska." "To," I said, "haan, Swami." "Tabhi doctor kya bolte?" "To, Swami, wo bolte ke phir operation hoga." "To," bole, "nahi, nahi, nahi operation nahi hoga." "Swami bola na, nahi hoga. Par saath de to." So I put out my hands. He gave me vibhuti and said, "Ye jaake uski jidhar pain hota udhar laga do." I went back to the hospital, applied the vibhuti. The child was, I mean, the son-in-law was by the evening more comfortable. But in the morning, they wheeled him into the operation theater for the operation. In 20 minutes, the surgeon in charge came back and said to me, "Sir, we're not operating on him now." I said, "Why, what happened?" He said, "Whatever the obstruction was, we put him on the table, the obstruction is cleared. So there's no need for the operation." And Naveen recovered fully, came back home, hale and hearty, just no problem. Now, you know, on this thing, we had a photograph of his in the house. And the day he came to our house, from that day onwards, Vibhuti started coming on that photograph. And it continued as long as we stayed in Bangalore. We moved that photograph to Delhi in our house when I became the chief of the air staff. And honey started oozing out of that picture. And it continued oozing till we stayed in air house. When I gave up my assignment and shifted over to another house, from the same picture, there was no honey after that. Now, to me, it is quite evident that there was his presence. There was his blessings on us the whole time. As long as I was doing a critical job, he was just there with me.
मेरे साईं की महिमा पार, मेरे साईं की महिमा पार, बाबा कलयुग के अवतार। सन 26-23 नवंबर पुट्टा पार्टी में जन्म लिया, छत्र नाग का था सर पर धरती को था धन्य किया, बलूते थे शंख मदंग मजीरे, तरफ था उल्लास बड़ा, झूमे थे धरी गगन, चौपासा था आनंद बड़ा, जैसे पतझड़ में आई बहार, जैसे पतझड़ में आई बहार,
मेरे साईं की महिमा पार, मेरे साईं की महिमा पार, बाबा कलयुग के अवतार, मेरे साईं की महिमा पार, बाबा कलयुग के।
क्या कुछ नहीं कहा,
तो क्या कुछ नहीं कहा,
तुमने बाबा ने सब कुछ सुना, सब कुछ सहा,
सब कुछ सुना, सब कुछ सहा, सब कुछ सुना, सब कुछ सहा।
मात पिता लोगों ने समझा, प्रकोप तभूत परेत का, साईं की लीला ना समझे, ना समझे रहस्य सुभेद का, तब साईं के हाथों कुमकुम निकली, साईं ने दिया लोगों को प्रमाण,
साईं ने दिया लोगों को प्रमाण, साईं ने दिया लोगों को प्रमाण,
एक ऐसी कौंधी बिजली भक्ति पे फूट गया शिरडी वाले, शिरडी वाले की मेरे साईं की, शिरडी वाले की मेरे साईं की हुई जय जयकार। एक इमली का पेड़ है चित्रवती तीरे
तीरे,
जहाँ साईं करते थे लोगों के मन का मंथन,
मंथन
देते थे संदेश उपदेश, जीता सब भक्तों का मन,
जीता सब भक्तों का मन, जीता सब भक्तों का मन।
एक इमली के पेड़ से साईं ने तोड़े फल न्यारे न्यारे, मन चाहा फल पाकर स्तब्ध रह गए साईं के प्यारे, साईं के देखो जी, साईं के देखो जी चमत्कार। बाबा झूला झूलते बोले यूं भक्तों से,
बाबा झूला झूलते बोले यूं भक्तों से,
जिस रूप को देखोगे पाओगे तुम मुझको ही,
रूप को देखोगे पाओगे तुम मुझको ही।
घटना घटी सबने देखी साए में कृष्ण छवि, झूला झूल रहे थे नंद लाला, गैया थे चरैया वाली वाला,
झूला झूल रहे थे नंद लाला, गैया थे चरैया वाली वाला, झूला झूल रहे थे नंद लाला,
देख कर अलौकिक ये दृश्य, मूर्छित सब हुए भक्त और शिष्य, मूर्छित सब हुए भक्त और शिष्य, तब साई ने की अमृत बोछा, तब साई ने की अमृत बोछार, कितना दृश्य वे सुंदर था साईं थे जहाँ समुंदर था,
कितना दृश्य वे सुंदर था साईं थे जहाँ समुंदर था, कितना दृश्य वे सुंदर था साईं थे जहाँ समुंदर था,
लहरों पर चल के साईं गए मझधारे, सारे लोग दंग थे खड़े जो थे किनारे,
कितना दृश्य वे सुंदर था साईं थे जहाँ समुंदर था, कितना दृश्य वे सुंदर था साईं थे जहाँ समुंदर था।
साईं ने लीला दुगुर दिखलाई, तब समुंदर ली अंगड़ाई, तब प्रकट हुई शेषनाग की सवारी, देखती रह गई ये सृष्टि सारी, साईं थे उस पर सवार, साईं थे उस पर सवार,
मेरे साईं की महिमा,
any suffering from a mere fault. We are woefully ignorant of the meaning of culture and the significance of spirituality and...
There has been a total crisis of character. Sanat had buried deep down with the ravages of time. It's at this juncture when skill has been
outstripping control, when science is laughing adhana, when fear have darkened the hearts of man. The world redeemer has come with this universal mission, with its four pillars of satya, dharma, shanti, and prema for the good of the whole mankind. The universal nature of Baba's techniques and the unity of the major world religions are proclaimed loud and clear by the Sarvadharma symbols carved and prominently displayed in Prashanti Nilayam. What is this universal religion that Sai Baba teaches? Its supreme message is the message of selfless love based on faith in the fatherhood of God and brotherhood of man. Only one religion, the religion of love. There is only one caste, the caste of humanity. There is only one language, the language of the heart. It is therefore no miracle that Christians who throng at Prashanti Nilayam from the remote corners of the West see him as Christ reborn. The Muslim devotees see in him their Allah. The Parsis see in him as Zoroaster.
The other important aspect of Baba's activities or the work which he's doing is emphasis on the universality of all religions. He always says that only one caste of humanity, and there is only one religion of love. He believes that all religions are like rivers flowing into the same ocean of divinity. So long as the river retains its identity, one feels as if it is a distinct river, a distinct religion. But once the river merges into the ocean of divinity, then all these distinctions disappear and we all get merged into the same ocean of divinity, whichever religion we follow. He therefore says, you follow any religion you like. If you are a Christian, follow Christianity. If you are a Hindu, follow Hinduism. If you are a Buddhist, follow Buddhism. And if you are a Muslim, follow Islam. But what he wants us to become is to become better Hindus, better Christians, better Buddhists, and better Muslims. Islam is a symbol of all religions. You have the Om of Hinduism, the crescent of Islam, the Dharma Chakra of Buddhism, the fire of Zoroastrianism, and the cross of Christianity. He is bringing about integration of the entire humanity without the people realizing that he is really bringing up such integration. It is a vast conglomeration of humanity coming from different regions, belonging to different countries, professing different religions. Baba has been telling that ultimately there is only one humanity, only one caste, the caste of humanity, and one religion, religion of love.
मुझे गुरु नानक देव जी के वो शब्द याद आ गए कि दूजा कौन कहां नहीं कोई सब में एक निरंजन सोई। और खूबसूरती की बात तो ये है, मैं कन्फेस करता हूं कि मुझे सिर्फ ये
The remarkable aspect is that I do confess not only there is similarity in the teachings of Guru Nanak Dev Ji and Satya Sai Baba, they seem to be identical, as if it is the same philosophy preached by two enlightened gurus. What was said by Guru Nanak Ji 500 years ago, Satya Sai Baba is reiterating the same after 500 years, as if the teachings of Guru Nanak Dev Ji are being granted a seal of approval by Satya Sai Baba, and what is propagated by Satya Sai Baba today is already authenticated to be the truth 500 years ago by Guru Nanak Dev Ji and other sages down the ages.
तफरकात आ गए हैं, उनके ऊपर जोर नहीं है, रिचुअल्स के ऊपर जोर नहीं है. छोटा सा उदाहरण लीजिए, सत्य साई बाबा तो उनके ऊपर जोर दे रहे हैं, लेकिन छोटा सा उदाहरण लीजिए, कैसे मुसलमान.
गुरु नानक देव जी हैज सेड दिस अबाउट द नमाज ऑफ मुस्लिम्स.
पहला सच, सच जो है वो पहली नमाज है. हलाल की कमाई दूसरी, हलाल दोए. तीजा खैर खुदाए, सबकी खैर मांगना ये तीसरी है. चौथी नियत रास रख, अपनी नियत को साफ रख. और पांचवी सिफत सनाए, खुदा की सिफत जो है वो करो. फिर करनी को कलमा समझो. देखिए कहते हैं कि मेर मसीद, मस्जिद जरूरी नहीं है, कंपैशन जो है वो जरूरी है. सिदक मुसल्ला, मुसल्ला जो है वो जरूरी नहीं है कारपेट जिसके ऊपर बैठकर आप नमाज पढ़ते हैं, लेकिन फेथ जो है वो जरूरी है. मेर मसीद, सिदक मुसल्ला, हक हलाल कुरान, कुरान नहीं जो हक हलाल की कमाई है वो जरूरी है. यानी जीवन को अगर बदलना है तो जो महापुरुष जिनके हम नाम देवा कहलाते हैं, जब तक हम उनकी तालीम को अपने अंदर उतार कर उसके ऊपर हम अमल नहीं करते, हमको उनका नाम लेवा कहलाने का कोई हक नहीं.
When you go to Prachandam or Whitefield or whatever Swami is, you will find devotees from all corners of the world, irrespective of religion, irrespective of color, irrespective of race, and all feel drawn together as members of one family, bound together by mutual love and respect and the common bond of devotion to the ultimate divinity to whom everyone is much attached. And for that, Swami tells us, you are all God. Every one of you is God, I am God. Only difference is you don't realize it, why I do. So the cream of Swami's teaching is, every human being is an embodiment of divinity. Once we recognize that, we will be able to get rid of all feelings of mutual differences, egoism, selfishness, and all kinds of, you know, the human weaknesses which morally degrade man. Once we get rid of them, we are able to elevate our consciousness and come into a level where this integration will take place. We will have prema towards all. Prema is unselfish love. That love has to be manifested in the form of service. Swami's trust is on all on service and the development and cultivation and restoration of human values. Just as Gandhi spread the ideal of non-violence and gave us independence, Swami, in his own very silent way, is working the miracle of bringing humanity together. A spectrum of which you can see in Puttaparthi when you go there any day. There is no corner of the world, there is no part of the world which is not represented by some devotees who have come from that part. There are persons from all over the world. There are persons from Africa. There are persons from United States of America, from Australia, from the Gulf countries. Every conceivable corner of the earth is represented. There are persons who have come long distances. What is it that is drawing them there? Only this love, infinite love of Swami, his compassion, and the conviction that has spread amongst devotees all over the globe that here is one ray of hope for the humanity, for the future, that instead of all this strife and war and the danger of nuclear, the complete destruction, there is a hope that humanity is saved by this great spiritual power that is now at Puttaparthi.
सबको बुला रहा है,
साईं बुला रहा है, मेरा साईं बुला रहा है, साईं बुला रहा है, मेरा साईं बुला रहा है.
He has established a campus which has been able to purchase peace from the world. It's one of the most peaceful places. It has a very pious atmosphere. It is disciplined in every sense of the word. And everyone seems to be a part of that campus, which is a very rare sight.
Though he is not making any conscious attempts at bringing global integration, till his movement and a vast number of admirers and devotees who gather, if I may say so, at his feet, do help bring about a global integration. People from all over the world, all nooks and corners, flock to his meetings, and I believe they get an opportunity to know what is happening in our country, what useful work our country is doing, what useful activities our country is engaged in, and what rapid advance we have made over the last few years. That is one aspect of Sai Baba's life and activities which needs emphasis, because unwittingly one can achieve several useful purposes as the purpose of global aggression is being achieved by Satya Sai Baba.
Even a casual visit to Prasantinilayam, where Swami stays more often, you experience an atmosphere of peace and tranquility, which is unmatched, unparalleled anywhere. I have seen as many as 6 and 10 lakh people there on certain occasions. And when he steps out, there is pin drop silence. In short, his very presence there spells peace. And peace not only for fellow Indians, but for people from all parts of the globe. And they mingle so freely with one another. They have affection for one another. They are all dedicated. And they are just chanting away his name. And it is amazing when you sit with them, you become one of the human beings. You are one people. You're not 6 million people there. You're not 6 lakh people. You're just one people. And all eyes are turned on this one small, frail individual who holds everybody spellbound. And what he says goes deep inside.
और ये एकीकरण की लहर सिर्फ भारतवर्ष में ही नहीं फैलती जा रही, बल्कि आप देखेंगे, सब कोई देख रहे हैं, पढ़े लिखे लोग भी, कि ये इंटेग्रेशन की लहर सारे संसार भर में फैलती चली जा रही है। और फैलने की वजह ये है कि उनको एक नया दृष्टिकोण मिला है, एक नैतिक मूल्यों का नया स्तर मिला है, आचरण का एक नया तरीका जो है वो मिला है। आज का साइंटिस्ट, साइंसदान बाहर के संसार खोज के अंदर तो लगा हुआ है, लेकिन जो खोजने वाला है उसको भूल चुका है। सत्य साई बाबा जो खोजने वाला है उसके बारे में जानकारी हासिल करने के ऊपर जोर दे रहे हैं। अगर उसकी तरफ हम ध्यान दें, यानी आउटलुक की बजाय इन लुक हो जाए, माइंड जो बिखरा हुआ है संसार के पदार्थों के ऊपर, ख्वाहिशात के अंदर, जिससे खुदगर्जी पैदा होती है, खुदगर्जी के साथ घृणा पैदा होती है, नफरत पैदा होती है, और वो नफरत जो है इंसान को बांटती जाती है ग्रोहों में, ग्रुपों में, जिसके साथ इतना तनाव, इतना खींचातानी, जंगें, लड़ाइयाँ, सब कुछ और तबाही के सब सामान इकट्ठे होते चले जाते हैं। ये सारा का सारा दृष्टिकोण बदल जाता है अगर इंसान अपने अंदर झांक कर देखे। अंदर झांकने के साथ ही उसका बिखरा हुआ मन ठहर जाता है, एकाग्र हो जाता है, फिर उसके कंट्रोल में आ जाता है। उसके अपने मन अंदर जब शांति आती है तो वो शांति वो अपने वातावरण में भी फैलाता है। इस वक्त इंसान को तमाम दुनिया के अंदर जरूरत है शांति की। अपनी अशांति से इंसान खुद बहुत ही दुखी है, लेकिन उस दुख के कारण को ठीक ढंग समझ नहीं पा रहा। अगर उसको अशांति का कारण समझ में आ जाए और वो उस कारण को समझने के बाद अपने आप को बदल ले, तो उसकी अशांति शांति के अंदर बदल जाएगी। ये लहर तमाम दुनिया में फैलती चली जा रही है, और मैंने खुद देखा है वर्ल्ड कॉन्फ्रेंस के अंदर। मेरे ख्याल में दुनिया के किसी कोई ऐसा कोना होगा जिसमें से बड़े बड़े अच्छे पढ़े लिखे विद्वान, फिलासफर, थिंकर्स, साइंटिस्ट, साइकोलॉजिस्ट, सोशियोलॉजिस्ट नहीं शामिल होते और शामिल होने के बाद प्रभावित हुए बगैर नहीं रह सकते।
Prashant Nilayam University, which has been founded by Sri Satya Sai Baba. I had the honor to inaugurate that university, and I can never forget the spellbound spectacle of that evening. 50,000 people were seated in a hall which had no pillars. Perhaps that hall had no pillars because the large number of students were gathered who are the citizens of tomorrow of this great country were the pillars of that institution.
Important items of work which he is doing. One is in the field of education and the other is in the field of bringing people together, bringing about integration. Baba is concentrating principally on education of the young boys and girls because he says that they are going to be the future citizens of India. And if we can inculcate moral and ethical values in them, then we can really build a great India universe full of love. And that is why he has started schools and colleges, and now we have got a deemed university in Puttaparthi. We have got a campus of that university in Puttaparthi, we have a campus in Whitefield, and we have a campus in Anantapur. And the education is given right from the primary stage up to PhD. We have got our own planetarium. We have got a computer center. We have got our own hospitals. Baba does not scorn or scoff at science. He believes that science has a vital role to play and science must go hand in hand with spirituality because it is science is like a motor car which has got an engine, but it's the steering wheel. Spirituality is the steering wheel which determines where this motor car will go.
This integration will take place, integration of the whole human race without any distinction of caste, color, language, creed or religion is bound to take place because already you will find when you go to Prashant Nilayam or Whitefield or whatever Swami is, you will find devotees drawn from all corners of the world, irrespective of religion, irrespective of color, irrespective of race. And all feel drawn together as members of one family, bound together by mutual love and respect and the common bond of devotion to the ultimate divinity to whom everyone is so much attached. And for that, Swami tells us, you are all God. Every one of you is God, I am God. Only difference is you don't realize it, why I do. So the cream of Swami's teaching is every human being is an embodiment of divinity. Once we recognize that, we will be able to get rid of all feelings of mutual differences, egoism, selfishness, and all kinds of, you know, the human weaknesses which morally degrade man. Once we get rid of them, we are able to elevate our consciousness and come into a level where this integration will take place.
की धारा
कण कण में समाई है साईं नाम की धारा,
ओ कण कण में समाई है साईं नाम की धारा,
कण कण में समाई है साईं नाम की धारा।
भटके हुए जीवन को मिल जाए एक सहारा, नदिया सागर से जब
मिले